How's it going, everyone? Ben Marouski here from FCP Euro with another DIY video. Today we are going to be doing an ignition service on this 2008 Porsche Cayenne Turbo. So today we're doing this basic ignition service on this 2008 Cayenne Turbo behind us. We are doing this as preventative maintenance, as this is a new car to us and we don't really know the service history. So it's not throwing any check engine lights for misfires or anything that would think that we have to do this right now. But because Porsche recommends it and we recommend it, we figured we'd throw packs and spark plugs at the car. So we are using the OE parts today. So we have the BorgWarner or Beru coil packs and we have the Bosch OE spark plugs. These come pre-gapped, so there's no messing with the spark plugs that we have to do, which is super nice. This is really a basic DIY with minimal tools. You don't need to jack the car up. You can do it right in your driveway with pretty much everything you should have in your garage, unless you don't have e-torques, but we'll go over that in a second. So aside from that, yeah, let's actually talk about those tools that you're gonna need to tackle this. So as you can see in front of me, I don't have many tools here because this is a very basic service to do on your Cayenne. All you really need is a T30, a T15, a 16 millimeter socket, a 16 millimeter spark plug socket. In our case, we're using CTA 7656, which is nice. It's a wobble head. It's got an extension built into it, and it's also got a rubber bottom so that it grabs the spark plugs. A 16 millimeter wrench to counter hold the upper torque mount bolt. And then you want a torque wrench that can go up to 46 pound feet of torque. And I also have a little bit of a persuader just in case it's difficult to get that engine mount back in. Other than that, really not much here. So with that said, let's just hop into the job. So the first thing we're gonna do is remove our cosmetic engine covers. For that, we just need to pop the washer fluid reservoir cap off, and using a T20, we will detach the reservoir from our cover. With that removed, we can begin to remove the covers themselves. For that, we just use a flathead screwdriver and pop out the plastic panel screws. Sometimes they can be a bit difficult, so be patient and pry underneath them a bit to help persuade them if need be. Depending on how many are left in your car, there should be about 4 per cover. We can remove this weather stripping a little bit, see a little bit clear, and this top one will come off. With the cosmetic engine covers removed, we can now remove the upper torque mount. We are removing this torque arm to have easier access to removing the cosmetic coil pack cover. For that, we will need a 16 millimeter socket and a 16 millimeter wrench to counter hold the nut. With the top bolt out, we can now remove the second bolt, also with a 16 mil socket. This one is held in by a captured nut, so no need to counter hold anything. Now that we have more room, we can begin to remove the 4 cover bolts. For that, we will use a T30 bit. For the one closest to the airbox with limited room, it's easiest just to use a T30 L key. These T30s are actually threaded into studs that hold the coil packs in, so don't be alarmed if the stud comes out with the bolt itself. It happens, and we'll actually address that later on in the video. Now that all 4 bolts are removed, you can just lift up on the cover and pull the tabs out of their slots. With the cover out of the way, we can now remove the wiring harness from the coil packs. For that, it's easiest just to push down on the tab and simply pull them out. So now is when we would normally remove the E12 studs that hold the coil packs in. With that said, our first 2 studs came out with our T30s, so we'll remove them from the cover later on. Now when doing an ignition service, I like to work at one cylinder start to finish at a time. So to remove the first coil pack, I'll just simply pull up and it'll pop right out. This tends to be easiest when the engine is a little warm, but it's not necessary. Inspect the coil packs for any tears and any sort of damage while you have them out. Before removing the spark plug, I'll take the time to clean up around the spark plug hole in the valve cover. While things are off, it's best to clean up around them to avoid contaminants from falling into the cylinder when removing the spark plug itself. Next, to remove our spark plugs, we'll again be using our CTA 756 16mm spark plug socket, which again is super nice because it is thin-walled, has a built-in wobble extension, and has a rubber inner sleeve to actually grab a hold of the top of the spark plug to help pull it out without any issues. With the first spark plug out, it's a good time to do a quick inspection to see if it's fouled. Ours is pretty oily up through the threads, so we may actually have an issue with our PCV system or spark plug valve cover gaskets. That's for a future DIY. Now, we'll just swap that out for our new pre-gapped Bosch spark plug. I like to stick the new plug right into the CTA socket and start to thread that in. Now, it's best to snug it down by hand initially, as cross-threading a spark plug into the head of the car can become a much, much bigger problem down the road, so if it doesn't feel happy going in, just back it out and start over. Once it's snug, we'll be torquing these down to 21 foot-pounds. With the spark plug torqued down, we can now simply push in our new Beru coil pack till it feels nicely seated. We'll repeat the same exact process for the remaining 3 cylinders, but we need to be sure to remove those 2 E12 studs that were in the last 2 cylinders that didn't come out with those T30s initially. This last coil pack can take a little bit of patience and finesse the snake in there, but it should pop right back in with a little finagling. From there, we can go ahead and push in our wiring harness back into each coil pack and you should hear an audible click once it's fully seated. Now before we install our e-torque studs to the coil packs, we do need to remove those two that came out with our bolts, so let's head over to the table and do that real quick. Now for this, you can just get creative. Here, I just used some vice grips to grab a hold of the stud itself. Now ensure you aren't grabbing the threads because you don't want to damage them. With the stud firmly counterheld, you can go ahead and thread out the T30s. To reinstall the studs, you may need to play around a bit with the position of the coil packs to see the threads in the valve cover. Be patient and pull up on the packs and play with them a bit till the studs thread in by hand. I like to pull up on the stud once I think it's seating to ensure it's actually threading into the valve cover and not the coil pack itself. It can be a little bit deceiving, so just kind of be patient with it. Now once they're all hand threaded in, we can grab our E12 socket and snug these down hand tight, or about 6 foot-pounds. Now that the coil packs are all snugged down with their studs in place, we can go ahead and reinstall our cover. Starting at the front, we just guide in the tabs of the cover until it feels fully seated. It should basically snap into place. Now hand thread in the T30s. This is similar to installing the studs, where it can take a little bit of playing around with how the cover sits over the threads to ensure that the bolts are properly threading into their home, into the studs themselves. Now once they're in place and threaded in, we can go ahead in with our ratchet and snug them down. From here, we just need to pop the lines back into their home across the firewall. And now we're going to be putting our torque mount back in. For this, you can work this into place by hand or with a hammer. It really shouldn't give you too many issues going into its home. We will then put back in our 16mm bolts. You may need to play with the torque mount a bit to get them to thread through nicely, but again, just pull up, push down, whatever you need to do to get the holes lined up. Once those are in place and hand snugged down, we can torque these bolts to 46 foot-pounds. Now, last thing left is putting our weather stripping back into place and reinstalling our cosmetic engine bay covers. For that, we will use our push-pin screws. You can either press them down till they seat or screw them in with a flathead. Now make sure you're lining them up with the metal tabs that they are supposed to push into. It can be sometimes deceiving if you're just pushing it into another plastic hole, but it should make sense. Now after that, we have our T20 for our washer reservoir, and we are all set to repeat the exact same process on the other side. Now when doing the other side, the process is identical, minus the torque mount not being there. But if you're having any issues getting to the front T30, you can remove the airbox by just removing the two dowel pins and two tabs of the airbox and lifting it out for more clearance. Everything else is the same and you should be good to go. So that does it for our ignition service on this 2008 Cayenne Turbo behind me. As you can see, this process is super straightforward. Really anybody can tackle it with basic hand tools. If you have any questions about the process or any of the things that we did in the video, please leave in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit that thumbs up. Be sure to also watch our Cayenne build, which features this exact car. And as always, subscribe if you haven't already. We will see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.